Welcome to all. Last class we discussed thermodynamic aspects of surface chemistry, means thermodynamic aspects of adsorption. In the delta G equal to negative, delta S equal to negative, and delta H equal to also negative. Delta H equal to negative means the reaction is exothermic. Why exothermic reaction? Means between adsorbate and adsorbate their bond forming. To break the bond, energy required. When bond forming, energy release. All adsorption process are exothermic reaction. Delta G negative, delta S negative, delta H also negative. Delta H equal to negative means adsorption is a exothermic process. Today we are going to discuss amount of adsorption. How we calculate how much amount adsorbate occupied on the surface of adsorbent? Very simple. This is, here it is. This is one adsorbent. This is adsorbent. Here bait particles occupied. These are the adsorbate. Listen, here it is. How many grams accumulated on the surface, that we called X. This unit area is there. This area we called M. So X is the adsorbate particles. M is the surface area of adsorbent. Now listen, here it is. Adsorption is equal to X by M. Just this is your marks percentage type, like that only. For suppose, out of 720, if you got 500 score, so what is your marks percentage? Means 500 by 720 into 100. This is your marks percentage. If you not taken this 100, that is fraction. Fraction is 0 to 1, percentage is 1 to 100. So here it is, I am calculating fraction of adsorption. Percentage of adsorption means into 100. Once again, it is not the separate formula. Here it is, how much surface area present, how much area occupied. Occupied area is X, surface area is M. So X by M is your rate of adsorption. Or else, how much fraction adsorbed there? Marks scored by you by total marks, this is fraction. Your answer is 0 to 1. Percentage means fraction into 100 is percentage. So here it is, fraction of adsorption or rate of adsorption is equal to X by M. This is, X is information about adsorbate particles. How many grams adsorbed? So here it is, M is there now. It is how much area is provided there. This is information about adsorbent. This information about adsorbate. So totally this we call rate of adsorption. So here it is, reason in this. I am taking, this is adsorption equal to X by M, means I am taking unit area. Means this M equal to, I am taking one unit area. If I am taking one unit area, on this one unit area, this X increases, what happens? Adsorption also increases. This X increases, this rate of adsorption also be increases. But please you don't take, here it is, surface area increases, adsorption decreases, not like that. Okay. So here it is, surface area increases, adsorption automatically, what happens? Increases. So that I will explain later, here it is. So simply, wherever we are taking X by M, that is rate of adsorption. In that rate of adsorption, X is the information about adsorbate, M is the information about what? Adsorbent. So this is amount of adsorption. Now we are going to discuss factors. Factors affecting adsorption. Factors affecting the adsorption.
So how which factors affect adsorption in which way? So that is the point here. First, suppose listen. Here it is, this chalk I am dipping in ink bottle, chalk I am dipping in water, chalk I am dipping in some milk, chalk I am dipping in honey. So rate of adsorption is different. So here it is like that, which factors affect the adsorption? First, suppose listen carefully. First, what I am doing here it is, I am taking here it is, simply this size duster I am taking. And this size duster I am taking. Where adsorption is more? So here adsorption is more, here adsorption is less. Or else, this is, you take, this is one vessel. In this vessel, I am taking helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon gases. I am taking 1 gram charcoal, I am taking 6 gram charcoal. Where rate of adsorption is more? So 6 gram charcoal when I was taken, the surface area is more. So that's why adsorption is more. So here it is reason, our adsorption depends on surface area of adsorbent. This adsorbent surface area increases, adsorption automatically increases. Simple example, in this vessel, I am taking same. First, suppose this is one vessel, this is one more vessel. In these two vessels, helium, neon, argon, like this gases, here also same gas I am taking. But here it is 1 gram charcoal I am taking. Here it is 6 gram charcoal I am taking. Where adsorption is more means, here adsorption is more. So here adsorption is less. So here it is, this adsorbent surface area increases, adsorption also be increases. So here what we are writing, first one, adsorption directly proportional to surface area. Surface area increases, adsorption automatically increases. Second point. Second point here it is, this is my duster. Same surface area contain one paper I am taking. This I am using to rub this blackboard. This paper I am using to rub this blackboard. When my work is easy, means duster. So meaning surface area same, but here adsorption means this chalk particles are accumulated or adsorbed by this duster effectively than paper. That's why instead of paper I am using duster. So listen here it is, say surface area same, but here adsorption is more, here adsorption is less. What is the difference between these two? Listen, duster is porous. Porous means it contains small, small holes. So here is, paper does not contain any holes. That's why listen carefully. Wherever porous particles present, that holes also act as surfaces. That's why compared to normal adsorbents, the porous particles contains more surface area. That's why they are, what happened? Adsorption is more. So second point here it is, porous particles adsorption is more. Adsorption is more. Example these two. Duster and paper, where adsorption is more means, for duster, here adsorption is more. Why for duster adsorption is more means, duster porous particles, the holes also act as surface area. So now next one. Here listen one more in this, what I am giving to you. This is coal. And here it is, coal powder I am taking. coal and coal powder means it is a block of coal, means it is a coal piece. I'm taking a powdered form where adsorption is more. Listen, coal means 1 gram total, both I am taking, it is 1 gram, it is also 1 gram, like this I am taking. For suppose this is 1 gram coal, so what area is outside, that is only surface here. But the same 1 gram coal, when I divide it into powdered condition, this inner side phase also come into surface. So now surface area, what happened? Surface area increases. It will come like this. So listen, when same compound we are taken in solid phase. Solid phase means block type, a rock type we are taken, the surface area is less. When the same compound we are taken powdered form, surface area automatically increases. So listen, powdered forms, contain more adsorption, and next one, here it is. Already we know rate of adsorption, this point, once again I am explaining. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, these are the noble gases are absorbed on coconut charcoal. Here coconut charcoal act as adsorbent. These are adsorbate. So those helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon gases are adsorbed on coconut charcoal. So now here it is, listen carefully. Here order you know already, here it is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. Xenon adsorption, rate of adsorption is more. Then krypton, then argon, then neon, then helium. Like this will come. So why xenon adsorption is more? Why xenon adsorption is more means, from helium to xenon, atomic mass increases. When atomic mass increases, van der Waal force of attraction, what happened? Increases. Atomic mass increases, van der Waal force of attraction increases. When force of attraction increases, the bond facilities also increases. That meaning, due to more mass, here what happened? More van der Waal force of attraction. Here less mass, less van der Waal force of attraction. Mass increases, van der Waal force of attraction increases. Van der Waal force of attraction is also a bond, but weaker bond. So listen, helium and xenon case, where chances there to form bond with coconut charcoal means xenon. Xenon, due to more mass, it can accumulate easily on the surface of coconut charcoal. So mass increases, van der Waal force of attraction increases, automatically adsorption increases. This is the point. But this much directly they won't ask the question. Here it is, question they relate to critical temperature. Critical temperature, this TC equal to 8A by 27 RB. TC equal to 8A by 27 RB. What is this critical temperature? Critical temperature means, here it is, I am taking this is X gas. I am taking at 25 degree Celsius, 35 degree Celsius and 40 degree Celsius, like this I am taking. In this cylinder, gas I am taking at 25 degree Celsius, this is piston. So listen, at this 25 degree Celsius, For suppose this X gas, for our convenient, I am taking carbon dioxide gas. Then here temperatures I am taking 25, 28 and 30. So like this I am taking degree Celsius. So I took carbon dioxide gas in this cylinder at 25 degree Celsius, I am applying pressure. Listen, temperature increases, already we know with our common sense. Temperature increases, gas properties, solid converted to liquid, liquid converted to gas. So means when temperature increases, the randomness increases. So more maximum randomness is possible for gases. So means high temperatures are favorable for gaseous phase. So now I am taking gas at 25 degree Celsius. I am applying pressure over this. When I am applying pressure over this, at this 25 degree Celsius, at a particular pressure, the carbon dioxide gas is liquefied. Now I am taking at 28 degree Celsius. Again I am applying pressure over this. Gas is liquefied at a particular temperature. At 25 degree Celsius also gas liquefied. At 28 degree Celsius also gas liquefied. But at 25 degree Celsius, the required pressure to liquefy that gas is lesser than at 28 degree Celsius. Why? Because temperature increases, the conversion of gas into liquid become difficult. Why? Because more is the temperature, that is more favorable for gaseous phase. That's why here it is, if I was taking 30 degree Celsius, same gas, same amount of gas, I am taking at 30 degree Celsius, I am applying pressure with the piston. Now also I can liquefy the gas, but the required pressure is more. So like that, temperature increases, the liquefaction of gas becomes difficult. So means the required pressure is increases. That meaning after a particular temperature, we can't give the pressure what is required for liquefy. So means after a particular temperature, whatever the pressure we apply, the gas cannot be liquefied. That we called critical temperature. Once again, listen carefully. When temperature increases, the required pressure to liquefy that gas also be increases. Like that, temperature increasing, pressure required to liquefy also increases, means after a particular temperature, even though we apply more and more pressure, the gas cannot be liquefied. So that temperature we called, which temperature? Critical temperature. Now here it is, these points I am explaining. A is a constant, this A is attraction. 27 is constant, R is universal gas constant, B is excluded volume. So here it is, this information you see, this is attraction forces. Now helium on coconut charcoal, xenon on coconut charcoal, where van der Waal force is present. Van der Waal force of attraction is depends on atomic mass. Here more atomic mass, more van der Waal force of attraction. So means this attraction force, where more present, there which is present, critical temperature also be more present. That meaning, listen carefully, helium to xenon, we know atomic mass increases, van der Waal force of attraction increases, so that's why adsorption is easy. But question they will ask, the following ABCD gases, their critical temperatures like this, which for which adsorption is more. Listen, we discussed up to van der Waal force of attraction. So this is the force of attraction, this is critical temperature, and these two are directly proportional. So means force of attraction and critical temperature, both are directly proportional. Where van der Waal force of attraction more present, there what happened, critical temperature also be more present. Where critical temperature more present, there also be attraction is more. That's why here it is, adsorption also be more. And again they change question like this. So more is the critical temperature, more is the adsorption. Next point here, write down. More is the critical temperature, more is the adsorption. Question they change like this. So here it is, more is the critical temperature, more is the adsorption. And one thing here it is, when critical temperature more present, the liquefaction of gas become easy or difficult. That is the point. Here it is, mass increases, van der Waal force of attraction increasing means, van der Waal force of attraction increasing means maximum attractions in solids, next attractions in liquids, next attractions in solids. So least attractions are in gases, next attractions are in liquids, attractions gas less than, liquid less than solid. Maximum attractions are present in solids, minimum attractions are present in gas. So now here it is, listen carefully. Attractions increases, here critical temperature also be increasing. Critical temperature increasing means, here I am giving to you, this is hydrogen gas or helium gas, any gas you take. Here I am taking carbon dioxide gas. This carbon dioxide gas critical temperature, this is 31 degree Celsius or 30.1 degree Celsius, exact value I am giving. After this temperature, whatever the pressure you apply, carbon dioxide cannot be liquefied. This is 4 degree Celsius. So means after this temperature, whatever the pressure you apply, gas cannot be liquefied. Now my question, in which case in these two, we are getting more chances to liquefy the gas? Is we are getting more chances to liquefy carbon dioxide or hydrogen helium? Listen, we are more chances to liquefy carbon dioxide, not this H2N, helium. Why? Because listen carefully, up to 4 degrees only we had a chance to liquefy these two gases. But this is up to 30 degrees Celsius we had chances to liquefy carbon dioxide. So means carbon dioxide gas has more chances to liquefy compared to these two. If this explanation is not understood, some more idea also. Listen, I am taking this hydrogen and carbon dioxide samples from atmosphere. So carbon dioxide sample I was taken, hydrogen sample I was taken from atmosphere. Atmosphere temperature, you know, that is 25 degree Celsius or 30 degree Celsius. So here it is, this 25 degree Celsius and this side carbon dioxide, this side hydrogen. Hydrogen critical temperature is 4 degree Celsius and carbon dioxide critical temperature is 30.1 degree Celsius. We are collected sample at 25 degree Celsius. We collected sample means from atmosphere we are taken carbon dioxide and hydrogen in two different cylinders. So we are collected sample at 25 degree Celsius means this 25 degree Celsius is below the critical temperature of carbon dioxide, but this 25 degree Celsius is above the critical temperature of hydrogen. So when we collected a sample at 25 degree Celsius and we are applying pressure over those two gases, this gas cannot be liquefied, but this gas liquefied. Why? Our sample is at 25 degree Celsius. This is below the critical temperature of carbon dioxide, but this is above the critical temperature of hydrogen. What is critical temperature? Means temperature above which whatever the pressure you apply over the gas, gas cannot be liquefied. That meaning this 4 degree Celsius temperature is the critical temperature for hydrogen, but hydrogen sample is present at 25 degree Celsius. So at this 25 degree Celsius, if we apply pressure over that hydrogen, this hydrogen gas cannot be liquefied. So how we can liquefy this hydrogen gas? First of all, you cool this hydrogen gas from 25 degree Celsius to 3 degree Celsius or 2 degree Celsius. At that 3 degree or 2 degree Celsius, you apply pressure over the gas. Then gas, this hydrogen gas also be liquefied. So up to what temperature we has to cool, that we called inversion temperature. But listen, here we no need to cool this carbon dioxide gas. This is its critical temperature is 30.1 degree Celsius. We are taking sample at 25 degree Celsius, means carbon dioxide is present below its critical temperature. So that's why here no need this inversion temperature, directly apply pressure, we can liquefy. Now from these two, what I am going to explain, this carbon dioxide gas is easily liquefied gas. But this hydrogen is not easily liquefied gas. In these two, which undergoes adsorption easily means this. Why? Because its mass is 2 gram, its mass is, it is 32 and 12, 44. So means more is the atomic mass, more is the van der Waals force of attraction, more is the critical temperature. So means when van der Waals force of attraction increases, adsorption also be increases. So here it is reason, hydrogen and carbon dioxide in these two easily liquefied gases, carbon dioxide, easily liquefied gases are adsorbed easily. So question they will change like this. Listen, simple technique, van der Waals force of attraction increases, compulsory adsorption what happen increases. But question they will ask in terms of critical temperatures, in terms of liquefaction possibilities. Here it is, critical temperature TC equal to 8A by 27 RB. Here mass increases, van der Waals force of attraction, it is the attraction constant. This increasing means this also increases. So means higher is the critical temperature, adsorption is more. Higher is the critical temperature, that gas is easily liquefied gas. So easily liquefied gas undergoes adsorption easily. And here it is one more. So totally we discussed here it is, one is, first one, more is the surface area, more is the adsorption. Compared to normal porous, more adsorption. Next one, mass increases, adsorption increases. Critical temperature increases, adsorption increases. Critical temperature increases, gas liquefaction become easily. Easily liquefied gas undergoes adsorption easily. And one more here it is. And here it is, one simple here it is. I am giving to you, this is H2 molecule and carbon dioxide molecule, and here it is, I am giving to you sulfur dioxide. So these are the, here it is. Now in this reason, here it is, this is hydrogen and hydrogen. Here it is carbon dioxide, CO2. And here it is sulfur dioxide. So now here it is, no need to take this hydrogen, this is enough, carbon dioxide. Here it is carbon hybridization, sp. Carbon is the 14th group element, valency 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 bonds there, that's why there is no lone pair. So sigma bonds plus lone pair 0, sigma bonds 2 means sp hybridization. Its structure is linear. Its dipole moment mu equal to 0. Sir, what is dipole moment? Dipole moment, movement between. Here it is carbon oxygen. Which electron activity more? Oxygen. So electrons moving towards which side? Oxygen side. Here electrons moving towards which side? Oxygen side. What about net movement? One is this side movement if I was taken plus, this side movement if I was taken minus, then net movement is 0. So that's why dipole moment is 0. Dipole moment 0 means that is
non-polar.
Mu equal to 0 means that is non-polar. It is a non-polar molecule.
And I am taking here it is sulfur. It's sulfur 16th group. I am expecting 6 valency. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bonds over here it is. So I am taking one lone pair 5, 6. So here it is, one lone pair present here it is. Now hybridization. Hybridization here it is. In this, hybridization is equal to sigma bonds plus lone pairs. Sigma bonds 2 and 1 lone pair. 2 sigma bonds, 1 lone pair, that is 3. 3 means which hybridization? sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization means 0 lone pair means triangle. Triangular shape. Triangular shape. And one lone pair means this is the, it is I am taking some, for suppose here I am taking BCl3, it is triangular shape. So here it is boron, here it is chlorine, here it is chlorine, here it is chlorine. Which shape? This is triangular shape. One lone pair means in this one place I have to replace with lone pair. Lone pairs does not involve in shape. Now the shape is, for suppose this I replace with lone pair, what happened? V shape. So here it is, this not involves in shape. That's why which shape coming there? V shape or bent shape. So SO2 present in which shape means bent shape. Bent shape here it is, sulfur oxygen, which is more electronegative? Oxygen. So electrons moving towards oxygen. Here electrons moving towards oxygen. This side movement present, this side movement not there. This side movement present, this side movement is not there. So now here it is, your net dipole movement is 0 or not equal to 0. Then I can say this is not equal to 0. Mu not equal to 0 means that is